idea from all of you how you try to bring in this kind of flexibility and agility into the organizations. That is a win-win situation for the organization as well as for the employees. How do you manage the compliance to the processes?
I think today's market is customers. What we are looking at internally and externally is satisfying customers very promptly, fast, and errorless. Now, system in place, in-house, and getting consultancy from outside are two different things, but have one goal, and I feel that is customer. Now, what happens is in-house, we have tried to do is, I'm from the regional processing unit, which is heading for Mumbai, where we have various branches who generate retail home loans, and we process it centralizedly at one office. Now, that takes place between the sanctions, disbursement, everything, and operations as well, including recoveries and collections.
There are the sea changes which have taken place, and for the last 5 years, if you see the changes taken place in the financial sector, despite that crisis in the global market, India withstood with all the changes and could show the performance. Without the experience of next 5 years, if you take the example of last decades, in the next one decade, it's very, very important for the financial sector to maintain the stability. With the sea changes taking place every day, customer demand is changing rapidly.
All the kinds of multinationals now coming to the country, because India is now the world's second fastest growing market. How do you scale up your existing processes and technologies to cope up with this variety?
Yes, this is a small point here. There's another perspective which I just thought that which I want to share, maybe I want to hear views with, is that normally in banks, or maybe everybody appreciates the importance of processes and standardization and all that stuff. And normally what happens is that you know, you have these process champions who are basically more at a corporate level and they drive the initiatives. But you know, moving down, but the thing is that the speed, they have ideas, they know what the problem is, you know, they can bring in process you know, changes or whatever it is. But getting it down to the level of implementation and moving it down to the branches, getting it down to, and actually one process of change, for example, you do a change in the process, rolling it out across, you know, to all your branches and everything, that takes quite a lot of time. So the thing is, the speed at which you do it is really actually slow, even though the process champion can come up with, you know, optimizations or innovations more faster in the process, but getting it down to the lowest level and to reap the benefits of it. Second thing is that there is always a big question on, you know, how do I really see the value of it in terms of, you know, it takes a long cycle for me to see my impact of the value in terms of ROI. So, you know, so that's where maybe the focus is moving towards, you know, systems which help in, you know, addressing these problems. And people are looking for bringing these, you know, IT team as well as the, you know, different groups together onto some common mechanism which, so that these ideas can move faster.
In banks, we have two types of processes. One are sequential and other are simultaneous. According to me, the challenge is first we need to automate the processes and try to convert all the sequential processes into simultaneous processes. For an example, a corporate applies to me, my bank, for a loan. Being a banker from public sector, I raise hundreds of queries. I do not do all other things that can be done, assuming that I'll get responses. I wait for his response, and that takes weeks, as he has said. So is it possible for us to put in place those processes and automate them, where most of the sequential processes can be made simultaneous, so that the time required for disposal can be made?
So what about innovation from employees? Would someone like to touch upon that? How did some examples, or how do you encourage employee innovation?
Coming to employees and innovation, see, it's always good to get employees to talk about what they want in life. Okay, so in HDFC Bank, we have a very strong program over the year, which is called Think Tank. All the employees at all levels, largely at the lower levels, at a certain level and below, they are encouraged to give suggestions on the processes that they are following and where they have the challenges, or they think that a minor change or a major change can bring a sea change in the organization. This entire program is run very professionally, and all the suggestions which come, and if I know correctly, in a quarter we get roughly around 1,500.